Welcome to the vlog. We are going to University of Esslingen. So if you're someone new to my channel, my name is Nikhilesh. I've been living here in Germany for quite a long time now. Even though I've visited Stuttgart so many times, but just for some reason it has never worked out that I just couldn't get a time to go to Esslingen University. It's one of the most toughest university to get selected. I have some friends who are studying and they will be giving us a campus tour of the university and life in general there. So I got off at University and I have my friends joining us on the campus tour.
Hi.
Hello.
He's studying MBA and you're studying DDM.
Yes.
That stands for?
Design and Development of Automotive and Mechanical Engineering.
Masters, yeah?
Yes.
Alright guys, so we have finally reached at Esslingen Neckar. If you look at the map, it will show you Esslingen bracket, like a capital letter N. That stands for Esslingen Neckar. Neckar is a river in Esslingen. Alright, so before I go ahead, I'll introduce quickly to my friends. Why don't you give us your introduction?
Hello, I'm studying Design and Development of Automotive and Mechanical Engineering in Esslingen. I'm from Hyderabad. I did my bachelor's in Mechanical Engineering.
And how much did you score there?
My CGPA was 9.93.
If your dreams got crushed after that, I'm not responsible for that, with that CGPA.
Hello everyone, I'm doing my MBA in International Industrial Management here at Hochschule Esslingen. I have a mechanical engineering background and a master's in advanced manufacturing. And I have 3 years of work experience working in an automotive manufacturing.
How can they reach here? What is the fastest way if they're flying for the first time?
Oh, if they're flying for the first time, they will definitely have a lot of luggages.
Yeah.
I would say they land in Frankfurt and then take a flight to Stuttgart.
Okay.
And then from Stuttgart come via a train.
Right.
We have S-Bahns and U-Bahns here and they can reach Esslingen. But it's generally a costliest way to reach here, to fly from Frankfurt to Stuttgart and then from. So you can also take an ICE,
yeah.
And then you can come here to Stuttgart Hauptbahnhof. And from Hauptbahnhof you have frequent trains visiting Esslingen.
Yeah, but the one which we just took. So there are a total of 3 campus of Hochschule Esslingen. There is one in Stadtmitte, which is in the city center. There is, what is the second one?
It's Flandernstrasse. It's a street name.
Okay.
We have a campus, Strasse Street.
Uh-huh.
It's a Flandernstrasse. We have a campus there.
And then the third one?
And the third one is called as a Göppingen.
It's not here.
It's not nearby here. We need to take another train. There are some courses that happen in Göppingen.
Mm-hmm.
So students travel from this place to that place via train. One.
Which bus will take us to the Stadtmitte campus, the main
Generally preferable bus is 111.
111. Towards?
It's towards Neckar Search. Then the bus is available in platform number 9, I think.
Alright guys, so this is what you get to see as soon as you are out of the station. There is a bus which will take you directly to the dormitories, directly to the university campus. And yeah, this is what it looks like when you come outside. One thing I noticed while coming to Esslingen was there's a lot of wineries around and there's a Neckar River across. I think from the front, I guess. So we took a bus from the Esslingen Neckar railway station. It only took us like 3 to 5 minutes. To get here. This bus stop called as Hochschule itself. This is what the area looks like around in front of the campus. So this is where we are right now. There are a total of 15 buildings here in the city center Stadtmitte campus. So out of both of you, you take most of your classes in this campus. And you go to the other campus?
Other campus, yeah. I go to the Flandernstrasse campus. It's also called as a hilltop campus because it's up the hill.
And how far that is from here?
From here is 10 minutes bus ride.
Again, we're going to take bus.
We need to take the same bus that we came.
Ah, okay. Go further.
Also.
Got it. Let's go further from here on. Are we going to building number one first?
Yeah, we'll go to
Let's go this way, yeah? Okay. So where are we right now?
We are in the international office. So here, the main international office, we have something called as career center. So once you come to Germany, you have an option to work as a student, as a work student, or you can do an internship, or you would want to do a thesis in the industries. So for these purposes, you need to apply it in German. Like most of the companies, they see your profile only when it is applied in German. The language, it needs to be in German. Your cover letter, your resume. So the career center here helps you in translating your document from English to German. And if you write your own German profile, they help you in correcting it for completely free of cost. You just need to send them a mail and then they reply you back with your suggestions and the format that is required for the German companies here. So it's a very useful place here at Hochschule Esslingen.
And then that is on the second floor. And then on
the
first floor, there's an international office.
International office. So,
okay.
I haven't known people who come to the offices here. It's mainly through mail because you can contact them via mail and they are really responsive. So they will really help you out if you send it via mail.
Over here you can see there is a language international office. You can actually enroll yourself for Spanish, Chinese, and French apart from German language.
So we are right outside this building filled with huge machines inside, prototypes. I would let her explain what really happens inside.
So we are here at the part of the laboratories, and the infrastructure and the machines that we have as part of the laboratories is very, very huge. You can see various machines that are used here are similar to that of the companies, so that you get in-hand experience and you're well acquainted with it, and you're also taught prototyping and how to work on it, and different aspects will be taken care of. One of them includes the index machine over here, which is from the index company, which is just few streets away from where we are standing. And when it comes to different machines, it also includes calculating the life cycles for a component that is used in a real car, where you will get to know how the component actually works and how you test. Even the test bench analysis is included, which is very good for a young engineer as far as the master's is concerned.
So right now we are in front of building number one. Seems like it's one of the oldest building, is it?
This is the first building and the oldest. It's from around 1857, I guess.
Okay.
Because there will be a poster inside,
uh-huh,
where you could see,
uh-huh,
the creator of the Hochschule Esslingen.
Have you had classes here?
Yes. All along my first semester and tentatively the second semester, but we had online classes, so we couldn't make it. But in the first semester, most of your classes, as far as the DM is considered, you will have it here.
Okay. So we showed you building number one, and right behind building number one, there is 3, 5, and 7?
Yes, 3, 5, and 7.
And you also have classes here?
Yeah, we had it in 7, the building 7. Most of them like mathematics and some few optics and vibrations.
So, as a student, how is Esslingen?
I would say it's a very beautiful place to stay and
yeah,
study. The experience here is really good.
Uh-huh.
It's a completely calm experience. And during the winters, it doesn't snow much here because we are at the bottom part of the hill when compared to Stuttgart. The winter can get extreme, but it's really good to stay here and study.
Yeah. How has been the part-time job experience for you both?
I did a work student here, so the moment I landed, I started applying for companies. Applying for companies can become a tedious process.
Okay.
Because this is the first time that I will be applying, and then you'll have to try out different ways in
yeah,
which the companies accept you.
Yeah.
And I started my work student at a company here,
mm-hmm,
just around half an hour travel from here. And then I work for 10 hours per week.
Okay.
It's pretty good experience, I would say.
You didn't come with work experience, right?
Yes.
You applied for this course when you were already in your 7th semester.
Yeah, I was in my 7th semester, then applied to this course.
Okay, okay. With the provisional degree.
Yeah.
Okay. You applied for how many courses when you were applying in German university?
I just applied to this one university.
And you got it?
And I got it.
And plan B was not there in
I did not have a plan B because either it was this university
or
nothing. I just continued working in
my company. Okay, in India.
So
and for you?
I had many other universities.
Mm-hmm.
In my hand as I had applied for around 8 universities.
Mm-hmm.
And then one of them was TU Stuttgart, TU Dortmund, Magdeburg as well.
Okay.
But I chose this one overall.
You got in how many of out of the applications you made?
Out of 8, I was successful in 5.
5, huh?
Yeah.
Wow.
But few of them I got acceptance after landing in Esslingen.
So you had no choice to change anymore.
I had no
anymore.
Choice. I couldn't move out. So I fell love in Esslingen.
See, if you're not familiar with the area, Stuttgart is also the headquarters of Mercedes-Benz, Porsche. So there are some headquarters of company in Esslingen also, right? Which ones are they?
Festo. There's a company called Festo. They have a headquarters here.
Yeah.
And most of the premium companies, they have their headquarters here, like as you already mentioned.
Yeah.
Mercedes-Benz, Bosch.
Yeah.
Festo. Mm-hmm. And there are many, there's a company called as Ebusch Praha.
Uh-huh.
So they are also have, they also have their headquarters here. So
and Index also?
Index, yes.
Would you say that the difficulty level to get into Hochschule Esslingen is very high?
Some courses, yes. Like the ASM, DDM, I would say is really competitive.
Okay.
But MBA, I wouldn't say easy either. But if you have a really good profile that explains your work experience, there's a good chance of you converting into an opportunity here at Esslingen.
What's your class strength?
It's only around 22 students from all over the world.
And in your class?
It's the same. We have a maximum of 23 students. That's the allowable limit. We don't have students more than 23.
And how many courses are taught in English?
So in Hochschule Esslingen, we have 3 master's degree program.
Okay.
That is a part of the graduate school.
Uh-huh.
The DDM, ASM and MBA.
Uh-huh.
Only these 3 courses are taught in English.
What's with this building number 6?
As you can see, the building behind me, it's actually part of our team projects that we were given in the last semester. It's when we actually worked on bearings. There is a big company called SKF that supplies bearings to the trains in all the Europe. So most of the trains derail. So we had to find out the most evident reason, and there are many reasons for it, but vibration analysis is the fast and the quickest thing. So there is a main test rig that would actually test the bearings of the company. So you will get to know the how to read the catalog and various things regarding bearings. So you will have a direct contact with the company. When you go back, you will have a parallel line of what you have learned and what you will be doing in the companies. So I feel this is best for it.
What is this passage? This looks like a like there is like shops around.
Yeah, this is actually a very good place for the students. You have the university there.
Mm-hmm.
And this is the Penny supermarket. It is one of the affordable supermarkets here in Germany. Most of the students, their weekly groceries, they come here to purchase, and it's pretty affordable and very cheap actually.
Right. I think the best thing is it's already here. So just in case if you don't want to eat in Mensa,
you can just come and grab something here.
So we are back at this square where we started the, you know, the campus tour. This is building number 10. There are classrooms inside, what it seems like, Gebäude. So now we will go towards the second campus. But before I go there, let me show you something. How beautiful this place looks. I think this is a restaurant on the campus itself. Wait a second, look at this. Oh my goodness.
So this is building number 1 on the Flandernstrasse campus. This is also called as a hilltop campus because we are on the top of the hill. This building mainly has the library here. The library is very beautiful. It's a huge library. And when you sit in the library, you can have a wonderful view of the city. And apart from this, we have classes here. And then the German classes also take place in the building number 1. This is our MBA block where we have specific class that is for the MBA. And we also have a dedicated project room wherein we can work in groups. We have our own self projector and tables and other amenities that is required for group works, we can work on the projects together in the project room.
So this is the second campus. Trust me, the view, what I'm about to show you, I can bet you can't deny not to come to Esslingen once.
So when students come here and they get a dorm that is near the Hilltop campus, you should get down at the Eugen Bolz bus stop. Like from the Esslingen Neckar, you take a bus 111 and then get down at Eugen Bolz Strasse, because that is the one that is nearer to your dorm. So it'll be easy for you to carry your luggages.
And also towards the university, I guess.
Also towards the university. Yes. Yeah. So after the university tour, we are here at the city center, and the building behind me, this is called as the Ausländerbehörde. So there are two main things that happens here at the Ausländerbehörde. One is the visa extension, and second is the city registration. Visa extension is the one that you actually come and do it here immediately, because you get only 3 months of initial visa. But once you come here, they will extend your visa until your end of your study. And second is the city registration. Here in Germany, once you move into a new city, you need to register in that particular city that this is my address. So you do the city registration here. And the way how you reach here is that from the Esslingen Neckar Bahnhof, it is just a 5 minutes walk. You can just put it in the map and then you can come. Or you can take a different bus from your dorm and then you can reach here. It is in the center of the city.
So just to add to what he said, the reason city registration is important, because that document will then help you to unblock your blocked account, and that will help you then to pay the bills. But to even go to the program where you will do your city registration, you need a house contract. That means you need accommodation and a house contract in your hand.
Okay.